Plot against the new developments at the bottom of the hour, just coming into Fox, involving the scientist Bruce Ivins, the prime suspect in the post-9/11 anthrax attacks. Sources are now saying Ivins, he apparently committed suicide last week, that he showed what they are describing as, quote, classic offender behavior after the attacks. This erratic behavior apparently was one of the reasons that authorities were closing in on him. Catherine Herridge has been working the story from the very beginning. She has these exclusive details. She's in D.C. with us. Catherine, what are you learning?
Okay, thanks, Jane. This morning we were able to confirm through two sources, one investigative and one federal, that Bruce Ivins, the scientist in question, did show these classic offender behavior after the attack. So we're talking about this period, mid-September until late October of 2001, when the letters were sent to various media outlets, also to Capitol Hill, and five Americans were killed. What's interesting is that this information about his erratic behavior is consistent with the profile of the perpetrator released back in 2001 by the FBI. They said you would typically see mood swings, pronounced anxiety, and also someone who had a preoccupation with the media. What we know from our contacts is that Ivins' behavior was in many ways consistent with this picture.
So he was classified as this sociopath, this homicidal killer, and he was still allowed in one of our labs handling the most dangerous and classified material?
Well, I'm not laughing because it's funny. I'm sort of laughing the way this story has come full circle, because you'll remember shortly after 9/11, because of the way the letters were written, immediately people cast their suspicions outside of the United States, and all of the investigative leads that we have been following for many years, and particularly in the last 18 months, have all led back to the Army base, Fort Detrick, and the research facility there. And yes, Ivins was allowed to continue working there until very recently.
Wow, Catherine, interesting stuff. Catherine Herridge for us in D.C., thanks.
You're welcome.
Folks,